Hallelujah. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one comes to the Father except by me, except through him. It was only Jesus Christ that had the audacity and the confidence to make this assertion, to make this claim, and to make this pronouncement. There is nobody who ever lived on earth who could make this demand or who could make this assertion. That means that Jesus is the only way to the Father. And earlier on, yesterday, I told you that the reason why everybody is afraid is that they are not sure of their eternal destiny. They are not sure of their eternal destiny. But I want you to know that there are people who know where they are going after death. There are others who know where they are going after death. If you are not in Christ Jesus, then you are not sure of where you are going after death. If you don't have a good relationship with God, then you are not sure of where you are going after death. This is the hour for you to iron out your differences between you and God. This is the hour. The opportunity is available for you so that you are not taken by surprise, because you don't know the day that Christ will come. You don't know the day that the world is going to end. You have to seize this opportunity and secure your salvation once and for all. Secure your eternal destiny once and for all. And Jesus Christ is the only way out. Jesus Christ has provided the way out for us. Listen to what the Bible said in Proverbs chapter 28 verse 13. Proverbs 28 verse 13. He said that the one who covers his sins shall not prosper, but the one who confesses and forsakes shall have mercy. The one who covers his sins shall not prosper. If you cover your sins, it shall not be well with you. Lay your sins open before God. People may not know about what you are doing, but God is aware of everything. Everything about your life, head to toe, it has been laid bare before God. Open the cards, open everything, make it plain before God. Whatever you have been doing in hiding, whatever you have been doing in secret, open it up before God and ask God to have mercy upon you. Ask God to forgive you. For the Bible says that the Lord is gracious, the Lord is merciful, the Lord is kind, the Lord is slow to anger, the Lord is a forgiving God. And so as you confess unto him, God will show you mercy. Don't try to be smart. Don't try to hide anything from God. Lay everything open to him, and God will show you mercy, and God will forgive you. Once God forgives you, your eternal destiny, your eternal abode have been guaranteed in Christ Jesus Christ. In Isaiah chapter 48 verse 22, Isaiah chapter 48 verse 22, the Bible says that there is no peace, saith the Lord, unto the wicked. There is no peace, saith the Lord, unto the wicked. That is why everybody has lost peace. Everybody is running helter-skelter. Everybody is confused because there is wickedness in their life. They are not connected to the Lord. When you are connected to the Lord, you know that it doesn't matter what happened. It does not matter what happens. When you die today, you will be in the presence of the Lord. You will be in a better place. So you are not afraid. The only cure for the fear, the only cure for the trepidation and the shaking of people's heart. People's heart is failing. People are troubled because there is no link between them and God. And the solution I am bringing you today, Jesus Christ, is the solution. He said there is no peace to the wicked. You should be able to have peace. You should be able to be at rest. You should be able to sleep and sleep well. It does not matter what happens. You will find a very good place to go. In Isaiah chapter 33 verse 11. Isaiah chapter 33 verse 11. The Bible says that, woe unto the wicked. He shall be ill with the wicked. For the reward of his hands shall be given unto him. So when you live in wickedness and you don't acknowledge God in your life, the Bible says that it shall not be well with you. It shall be ill with you. It shall be detrimental unto you. In Isaiah chapter 13 verse 11. Isaiah chapter 13 verse 11. The Bible says that I will punish the world for their evil and the wicked for their iniquity. And I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease. And I will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible. I will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible. As you can see, everybody has been laid low. The rich have been laid low. The great have been laid low. The affluent have been laid low. The influential have been laid low. Everybody have been laid low. We have seen how powerless we are. We have seen how weak we are. If God shakes himself a little, all of us will be gone. All of us will be destroyed. All of us will be finished. But there is a place of security in Jesus Christ and in God himself. And God is saying, come unto me. Come back unto me. I am your salvation. I am your redemption. I am your security. Wherever you are watching me from, there is security for you. There is salvation for you. Don't be afraid of your tomorrow. Don't be afraid of your eternity. It is already paid for. It is already secured. And I am showing you the way out. That way is in Jesus Christ. He said, I'll punish the world for their evil. Isaiah 13:11. And the wicked, I'll punish them for their iniquity. I'll cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease. I'll cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease. Here we are. All our pride have been arrested. All our arrogancy have been crippled and have been detained because of a small virus. There is an almighty God that is calling for your attention. Give him your attention and you shall be safe. I shall bring my message to a conclusion. Isaiah chapter 26 verse 10. Isaiah chapter 26 verse 10. The Bible says, let favor be showed unto the wicked, yet he will not lend righteousness. In the land of uprightness, he will deal unjustly, and he will not behold the majesty of the Lord. The Bible is telling us that it doesn't matter the opportunity you give to the wicked and the unrighteous. They will continue in their unrighteousness. Precious one, I know that is not your intention. You want to give the Lord a chance in your life. You want to allow God to take over. You want God to do what he wants to do in your life. So wherever you are watching me from, pray this prayer with me right now. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I thank you for your word. I believe and I have received your word. Have mercy upon me. Forgive me for your name's sake. Wash me with your precious blood. Come into my heart. Be my Lord and my Savior. Let my life be a testimony to those who know me. Lord Jesus, secure me in your book of life. Thank you, mighty God, for answering my prayers. Amen. Your life is never the same. You have become the Lord's property. You have become the Lord's child. And from now on, you are secure. Make sure you remain in Christ. And God will give you the grace to do that. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. We'll be right back.